Rocky Horror is one of those things that means so much to so many people.
Yes, it's terribly emotional and people quiver and quake. I love my Rocky Horror fans because they're very special to me. And somebody's coughing. And I like them, see? And the thing is, little Nell and I were on TV in Seattle, and it's a woman's program with a live audience, females. And the woman said, we came on, and we were in our Vivian Westwood and whatever, to the Time Warp. This is just a year or so ago. And she said, do you girls never get tired of these Comic-Cons? And Nell said, well, it's very nice to be worshipped. And the woman said, oh, I could do with a bit of that. And Nell said, get a dog. Because what happened was we began upstairs in a 60-seat theater at 18 quid a week, which I handed to my nanny, okay? And they said 3 weeks. And I said to my agent, what is this show about? And he said, I think it's something about a circus. I said, all right. Nobody knew what it was about because it wasn't written. Anyway, but he wasn't wrong because I've been in this circus ever since. I have been around the world and I can join this circus anywhere on the stage where I like, and I do. I've been in Dortmund, I've been everywhere because I can just go in dressed as Patricia Quinn, sing science fiction as Patricia Quinn, because I don't have to interfere with the actual show, and get a bouquet and take a bow. And I said when I was first asked back to it, they were doing it at the Piccadilly Theatre, and they said, would you sing the Usherette? And they were getting people in like Chrissy Hynde and people just to attract more audience, okay, just to do Usherette, so it can be done. And I said, jokingly, I said, I feel like a diva. I said, I'm sort of a Maria Callas. You know, I go in, sing my aria, and pick up the envelope. I like envelopes. Okay. So this was amazing. I was in Milan promoting for 20th Century Fox, the DVD. And they sent me to Milan. In Milan, there's a Cinema Mexico. It's massive, Rocky Horror. And our names are all on the wall. Richard O'Brien, Pat Quinn, whatever. We've all been there. Okay. So then that evening, I go to the National Theatre of Milan to go in and sing science fiction because it's on the road, the show. Sing science fiction, get my bouquet and leave. And I get to the National Theatre of Milan in my chauffeur-driven car from courtesy 20th Century Fox, and I arrive at the Square of Magenta. And I thought, good Lord, I know there's a Boulevard of Magenta in Paris because I saw it. And I thought, I'm at the Square of Magenta. And I go to the National Theatre of Milan, I look across the square, and there's La Scala. Oh my God. That's right, I am Maria Callas. But like in Amadeus of the Common People's Theatre, you know, because that's like the Simon Callow Theatre of Amadeus, where Mozart used to like to hang out and have a good time. So that's what it was like. It was an extraordinary coincidence, all of that.